Oh, awesome. It's working. Hallelujah. All right. So today we're out here. We're with the church. It's called Home Church. We come out in the community. We come out in different areas. We go to Clearwater Beach. We go to the Sponge Docks here. We go all over the place. We go to Dunedin. We go to Sims Park. We travel all over the place, usually in the Tampa Bay area, because our goal is taking the gospel to the streets, because Jesus says we should go out and make disciples of all nations. So we believe that is practical. We believe Jesus says that we should go out and we should actually tell people about him, share about him. So we want people to know that Jesus Christ is coming soon, and that now is the time to become born again. Now is the time to live right with Jesus, because the time is running out. Jesus says not everyone who says Lord, Lord will enter the kingdom of heaven. So that means you can't say you're a Christian and not obeying Jesus. You can't be living in fornication. You can't be just bound by pornography and all these different things. These are things that God can deliver you from. So we come out to share the true gospel. We come out to share a gospel that Jesus said is the good news. The gospel where we have the ability to get a fresh and clean slate. Jesus says that nobody will go to heaven unless they become born again. Nobody goes to heaven because they're a good person, but a born again person is the person that goes to heaven. Because every single person has fallen short. There's not a single person that's perfect. Every person has fallen short. So what Jesus says is that if we become born again of the water and of the Spirit, he will give us a brand new life. He will send his Spirit to live inside of us, and he will help us to live a life that's pleasing to him. God loves this world so much that he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. There's so many people, they have life insurance, but they don't have soul insurance. So many people are on their way to hell because they don't know Jesus Christ. They don't know the Savior of the world. So we go out and we tell people about Jesus because we know he's coming soon. And Jesus commanded us. Jesus says, when you receive the Holy Spirit, you will be my witnesses. Amen. Go out in the world and share the gospel. Amen. Preach the gospel to all creation. So we come out and we share about Jesus. We don't just share Jesus here in the Sponge Docks. We share Jesus in Dunedin, in Clearwater Beach, in Sims Park, all over. Because we believe that Jesus is coming soon, and people need to know about it. People need to know that if you die living in your sin, you're not going to go to heaven. Jesus Christ is giving us an opportunity to have a brand new clean slate. Jesus is saying, in order to get to heaven, you must be born again. Amen. You must be born of the water and of the Spirit. Nobody goes to heaven because they're a good person. If here on earth we commit a crime and we go to the judge will give us a sentence. And the judge may say, your fine is $500. But if somebody pays your fine in a court case, your case is dismissed if somebody pays your fine. So spiritually, Jesus Christ paid our fine because he died for the sins and the things that we did wrong. And if we trust in Jesus, our case can be dismissed before the Father. So Jesus is offering a new life. He's offering a clean slate. He's saying, come all who labor, come all who's weary, and I will give you rest. Jesus Christ is at the door, and he's reaching out to this nation, and he's saying, now is the time to repent. Now is the time to get right. When we look all around, we see that we're living in a culture that's pushing for a cashless society. We see we're living in a culture that's pushing for biometrics and human DNA to be mixed together. We live in a culture where we see that they're trying to implement a one world religion, where they're trying to implement the mark of the beast. And I tell you, these things are written in the Bible, and it's very close. Right now they have what's called an RFID chip, and there's a company in Wisconsin where every person who works in that company has to have this microchip in their arm. And if they don't have it, they can't enter work, they can't even purchase things on the job without this microchip. But the Bible makes it specifically clear in the book of Revelation that in the last days he will force all, great and small, to receive the mark in their right hand and in their forehead. So we're living in a time where the mark of the beast is so, so close. So the church now has to go out and tell people the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Now is the time to repent because Jesus is coming soon. If some of the things I'm saying, I want you guys to look them up. Because these are not just opinions. These are not just me giving a theory. Look up RFID chip. Look up the cashless society. Search these things. These things are things that are actually happening. These are things they're actually pushing for. And the Bible talks about it, how he will force all, both great and small, to receive the mark in their right hand or their forehead. And now we live in a society where you can see all this coming into place. And Jesus is saying, now you need to repent. You are seeing glimpses and pieces of this coming together, and now is the time to get right with me. Now is the time to receive my forgiveness. Some of you, God may have spoken to you when you were little children, and you just kind of pushed that voice away when God was calling you to be in his army, when God was calling you to be his disciple. And I'm saying now, Jesus is saying, now is the time to serve me. Now is the time to awake and serve me, because the time is running out. And as Noah preached and told them that there was a flood coming, and people mocked him, people scoffed at him, so I come and preach about Jesus, and some people will completely ignore what I'm saying. But Jesus made it very clear that he's coming as a thief in the night, and so many people are not going to be prepared. But Jesus says, if you serve him, you need to always be ready, because you know not what hour the Lord coming. And he said that he's coming very soon. As people mocked Noah and made fun of him, what happened? The flood came and so many lives were lost. Only 8 people were saved. And I tell you this, even scientists can say that the earth was once flooded by water. Even scientists can testify of the fact that this entire world was flooded by water. And that just validates the Bible. So I tell you that Jesus is coming soon. He is at the door. We're living in the last days, and he's calling all to repent. He's calling all to come to know his son before it's too late. God is not condemning anybody. God is pleading with us, and he's saying, now is the time to get right. Now is the time to receive the forgiveness of my son, because I am at the door. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. There's so many people who struggle with anxiety. There's so many people who struggle with depression. There's so many people who have addictions and different problems. But I want to let you know that Jesus Christ is a deliverer. Jesus Christ is a healer. Jesus Christ is not just a prophet. Jesus Christ is not just a good person. He's the Son of God who came and died for our sins and rose again on the third day. And he died so that we can have life and life more abundantly. There's so many people who live in shame. They live in guilt. They live in rejection. And so many people grew up without a father. So many people are hurt. But God wants to be the father that you've never had. God wants to be in a relationship with you so you could know him, and that you could have a relationship with him. You can't go to somebody's house unless they know you. So it's the same thing here on earth. You need to know God here so that when you go to heaven, he knows you and he can let you into his kingdom. And the Bible tells us how to live a life that's pleasing to God. It's not just saying, I believe in Jesus and then live like the devil. That's not how you get to heaven. When you say you believe in Jesus, that belief has to have an action. There has to be a change in your life. There's going to be a transformation. Because the Bible says that when you've come to Christ, the old has passed away and all things have become new. He promised that he will send his spirit to live inside of you and give you a transformed life. Jesus Christ can set you free from the things that you're struggling with. He can set you free from the addictions. He can set you free from depression and anxiety and just all these different things that plague so many people in the world. His word promised that he can give us a peace that surpasses all understanding. And Jesus is knocking at the door. The Bible talks in the book of Revelation. It says that Jesus Christ stands at the door and knocks. And he says, if any man opens up, he will come in and commune with him. So even now, when things are good in your life, Jesus is outside that door knocking. When things were rainy, Jesus was outside that door knocking. When things were crazy in your life, Jesus was at that door knocking, and he's waiting for you to open that door so he can come in, so he can have a relationship with you, so he can save you from your sin. Because if we live in sin, this sin is going to send us to hell. As a matter of fact, when Jesus started his ministry, the first words out of Jesus' mouth when he started preaching was, repent. Amen. For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And without repentance, there is no forgiveness of sin. So I tell you, you need to repent, and God will forgive you, and he will give you his spirit and give you a transformed life. I tell you that Jesus Christ is knocking at your door. So many people
have been turned away from God because of things that happened in their life. Maybe somebody died or different things that come up. But I want to let you know that God is not scared of your questions. Don't let your questions push you away from God, but let your questions run you to God so you can ask Him, because God will answer your question. He will answer it through a person. He will answer you supernaturally through a dream. But let me tell you something. God is speaking. Jesus Christ is alive. He says where two or more are gathered, there He is in the midst. And I want to let you know that Jesus Christ is here on the streets today, and the church is here. And I want you to know that Jesus is reaching out and He's speaking to your heart. There's so many people who may hear my voice and you feel like the Holy Spirit's tugging you. Please don't harden your heart, because the Bible says if you harden your heart, it's pushing you further away from receiving the truth. And if you keep pushing yourself further away, you may go to a place where you won't hear the voice of the Lord anymore. You won't hear. You will sear your conscience to it. So as I come here and I talk about Jesus, I want you to know that He's pleading with you. Because the Bible says, for God so loved the world that He sent His only Son, that whosoever believe in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but the world through Him might be saved. Every single person in this world took a path. The Bible says we were all born in sin. This world is a fallen world. When some of us born, we became thief. When some of us are born, we become homosexuals. When some of us are born, we become murderers. When some of us are born, we become liars. But we all took a path because we're born in sin. You don't have to teach a child to lie. You don't have to teach a child to do certain things wrong, because there's a certain nature that we adapted from Adam. And Jesus Christ is the cure. Jesus is saying, I can transform your life. I can transform you. So I want you to know, this is why Jesus says, it doesn't matter what aspect of life or what category you're falling into. Jesus says we all must be born again. We all have to be. It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter. Jesus says you have to be born again. There is nobody in history that has affected the world like Jesus. Jesus has affected the world so much, we have books that say AD and BC. So we see that He literally restart everything. After Christ, before Christ. So we see how powerful the presence of Jesus is. And it's because He left such a mark on this earth, because He was not just a man. He was God in the flesh. Jesus Christ came down here to show us the way. He showed us how to enter into the kingdom of God. And that is through Him. You know, there's a lie now going around in the world that there's many ways that leads to God. But I want you to know, there are not many ways that leads to God. I have one phone number, and you cannot get me from any other number besides that phone number. And there is one way to the Father, and that is through the Son, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I let you know that Jesus is pleading. He's reaching out to you. He's saying, now is the time to get right with me, because the time is running out. Now is the time to build your house upon the rock. Jesus says that if you keep your life, you will lose it. But if you lose your life for His sake, you will find it. Jesus says that if a person hears His words and keep them, He will reckon him like a wise man who built his house upon a rock. And when the floods came and the wind blew, that house stand, it didn't fall. But if you heard His words about repentance and the forgiveness of sin and receiving the Holy Spirit and living a transformed life, and you reject it, you would be reckoned unto a foolish man. And when the wind comes and the flood, your house will not stand. God wants to be in the midst of everything you do. God cares about every single detail of our life. And God is trying to be a part of it. If you don't have God as a part of your life now, when you're not living according to the standards of the Bible, you're not going to be able to enter into the kingdom of heaven. Jesus Christ is pleading with this nation, and He's saying, now is the time to get right with me. I have suffered long with mankind. He says, I don't wish for any to perish, but I want to see all come to repentance. God's love is reaching out to the world, and He's saying, I love you, but you have a cancer, and that cancer is sin. And I have the cure, and I want to fix the situations that are in your life. I want to step in. I want to be in the midst of everything you're going through, but you have to let me in. You have to realize that you need a Savior. You can't save yourself. Nobody's going to go to heaven because they're a good person. Nobody's going to be able to boast about it. Salvation is a free gift. Jesus Christ, what He did on the cross was a gift. that he now extends to you and said, here, here is forgiveness. And as I mentioned before, if I was speeding here and the cops pulled me over and gave me a ticket and I went to court and they gave me a fine and they said that fine is $1,000. And if somebody steps in that courtroom and says, Andy, I'm going to pay your fine, and they paid my fine for $1,000, my court case is automatically dismissed if somebody pays my fine for the wrongs that I did. So Jesus, spiritually, he did a transaction for us where he paid for our sins on the cross. He paid for the wrongs that we did so that if we repent and trust and believe in him, when we stand before the Father, our case can be dismissed, that we could be accepted into his kingdom, that we could be his children. God doesn't want to see anybody go to hell. The Bible says that hell was created for the devil and his angels. And the devil is trying to deceive us. He's trying to make us find pleasure in money. He's trying to make us find pleasure in other people. He's trying to make us seek for love in all the wrong places. When God is saying, the void that is in your chest, I want to fill that void. Jesus is saying, that emptiness that you feel, I'm the one who can fill that. And you won't find it in the world. The world, you will not find the things that fulfill you. Everything in this world is vanity. It's absolute vanity. Everything will go. On this earth, we live for a period of time and then we will go into eternity. And every single person on this earth is in a side. Every single person is literally in a kingdom. There's two kingdoms. There's the kingdom of darkness and the kingdom of light. And the Bible makes it very clear that every person is on a side. Do you know where you will go if you were to pass away today? If you don't know, that should be scary, because that could be an indication that you're on your way to hell. And Jesus is saying, hey, I am the solution, I'm the cure. Jesus is saying, and if you repent and trust in me, you can inherit the kingdom of God. But if you reject the message of the cross, if you reject the message and you scoff and you laugh, some of you, this may be your last message hearing about Jesus. Some of you, this may actually be your last message. Nobody knows when they're gonna pass away.